Mastodon and Remission in particular were really important for reinvigorating American metal at a time when new metal was still dominating.
When I heard them, it was Life's Blood first, but Remission was like, you know, when your head exploded.
Just so different from what everything else that was going on. The first record just had so many great tracks on it, like super heavy, kind of progressive, kind of not, kind of this, kind of that. Just they appealed to such a wide range of people.
You know, I was very excited about when that record came out because it was like, you know, our first full-length record with, you know, these new guys that I've been jamming with. That was really when we started writing together as a group.
It's kind of hard to describe what makes them unique, but when you hear it, it just sounds unique. It's hard to quantify or to, you know, really say what it is that they're doing differently than everyone else, but when you hear it, you know what it is.
The drumming was exciting and just so colorful, and I don't know, like, is they're really hard to pinpoint their influences, you know? It just seemed like such a fresh idea.
You know, it's four guys coming together and experimenting and not really worrying about anything other than expressing themselves.
It was really what metal needed at that time. You know, bands that could play, like true metal bands.
They packaged themselves in this stoner, I mean, almost, you know, angling into deathy kind of noise sound, but they're so progressive.
And if you think about it, it's almost like sort of New Orleans style sludge mixed with prog, almost like Dream Theater type progressions and everything in there.
As soon as you say the name of the band, you know, you kind of have this like sound locked in the back of your head of exactly what that is. Of course there was sludge and grind and rockabilly before Mastodon, but they put it together in this way that spawned a whole new collection of bands that really try to follow in their footsteps.
I mean, you had kind of the resurgence of the Swedish mellow death movement influencing what was happening in New England at the time. You had nu metal kind of at its peak. Nobody was really doing anything as aggressive and as dark as that was in that world.
A lot of like classic debut records, the people that do it come from established bands and they learn what to do and what not to do for their new project.
So Bron and Bill were in a band called Today's the Day, which I was a huge fan of and we toured with, and then they formed Mastodon with Brent and Troy, and were also signed to Relapse with Today's the Day and Dillinger. So very early on, we were touring together. We became really close friends really early on, and that record was great because I had no idea where that band would go.
You know, it was just such an experimental time, I guess, for us, because we didn't know really what direction we were going, and we just had these riffs and these songs, and it all came together.
March of the Fire Ants was immediately stood out amongst the other songs because when they played it live, you saw it connect with the crowd immediately.
I think that song, we realized that it was like a real hit when we played it in front of a lot of people at a festival, and like everybody started going crazy during the beginning opening riff. It was kind of written by accident, you know, and it's a very simple song.
The minute he opens his mouth, it's just like, there's that voice. It just sounds so instantly familiar and so unique and so compelling.
High on Fire, Mastodon, and Total Fucking Destruction were playing a show at the Balcony Bar at the Trocadero. So this is a show with like capacity of 175 people. Got there, watched Total Fucking Destruction, it was fun. And then I was like settled in to watch Mastodon. By the time Mastodon finished their set, I completely forgot that I was there to see High on Fire in any way possible. They blew my mind.
It had everything I wanted to hear. It had the super aggressive vocals with like really beautiful melodies. And what was really cool about that record is there's a lot of space. You know, they kind of took the Neurosis approach of like the simplicity of like the lyrics and stuff like that. You know, it made each word count.
They would tour with extreme bands a lot back then, I remember. You know, they'd be on tour with Phallic Carnage. That's when I first saw them. And it was just like, just phenomenal, dude.
And to see a band that started out as just a bar band out of Atlanta grow to the heights that Mastodon has is awesome to see.
Not to put down Remission, it's obviously a classic record, but I think Mastodon has just gone on to way greater things.
I miss them when they were like that, when they were more aggressive and more, you know, for the throat. Like now, you know, they're kind of gone in so many directions, you know, and have kind of become a more progressive kind of band.
They've changed their sound a bit. They've definitely gotten proggier, more towards like the Rush Yes side of things.
Even though Remission will always be one of my favorite Mastodon records, I do understand that their evolution and boundary pushing, even way back then, is what makes them a truly great band.
To see them grow and thrive and become a band that is capable of appealing to mass metal audiences, but also have an artistic aesthetic and a real unique sound, is very rare.
And still, that first record is one of, if not my favorite, definitely in my top two favorite Mastodon records.
That record was ground zero for an amazing career that continues today. You know, definitely one of the best bands going.
It was just that magical moment of the four of us like creating music together for the first time, really.